Are you ready for your destiny?
Yes.
Are you ready for your new encounter?
Yes.
Are you ready for your fresh encounter?
Yes.
Are you ready for the new year?
Yes.
A continuation of acceleration. Recharge. Somebody just say, recharge.
Recharge.
Now, in the past, God has given us our words. We're not trying to be funny. We're not trying to rhyme things just to have fun. We're trying to get the mind of the Lord, the heart of the Lord, as sons of Issachar. We want to understand the times and the season in which we're in. By the way, this church is so favored by God, is it not? Gates of hell cannot prevail against God's church. But starting a few years ago, God started to show me all these R words. And they're not just words, they're revelations. I'll say it again. They're not just words that start with a letter, but they're revelations. I'm tempted just to preach on every one of them tonight. But we started with restore. Restore. Man, that's a revelation in itself. The Lord's not going to return until the restoration of all things. Acts 3:19-21. Regroup. Sometimes you just got to regroup. Redeem. Rebound. Oh, we know about that. Rebuild. Some of you are in a rebuilding process in your life. That's okay. Repair. Refresh. Renew. Replenish. Have you figured out by now God always replenishes? Regain. Rejuvenate. Reward. Relax. Rest. Rescue. Renovate, release, relaunching, and then last year, an A word, acceleration. And now this year, coming into 2018, a continuation of acceleration, and another R word, recharge. Somebody shout, recharge.
Recharge.
2018, we will accelerate faster. Hear me. If you think this year went by quickly, hold on. In 2018, we will accelerate faster, quicker, and hear this word from the Lord. More suddenly movements. More suddenly movements. It means you can close your eyes and open them, and it'll be gone. Or you can open your eyes. Depends how you see it. Just open your eyes, and bam, there it is. Being in so quickly in position, knowing that you're ready right there on the spot. Suddenly moves of God. The word recharge. Listen to this. To replenish upon reconnecting. Wait a second. There's another R word which we have not used. I just said it. Reconnecting.
Amen.
Talk about the continuation of acceleration. It's happening right before your eyes. Recharge, to replenish upon reconnecting. That's acceleration. Recharge, to plug in. Recharge, somebody get ready, to regain strength. I said to regain strength. Recharge, to renew. Listen to this. Recharge, to draw power from another source. You get it? Recharge, to draw power from another source. Recharge, fresh impartation. recharge, to transfer over, to replenish upon reconnecting, to plug in, to regain strength, to renew, to draw power from another source. I'm telling you right now, God's telling me right now, there are people in this room that you meant well, but you operated in your power. I'm hearing God say, some people in this room have treated God's money like it belongs to you. This ain't scripted, folks. None of this is scripted. And God's saying, if you take everything that you have and treat it like it's His, He will give you things you've never even seen before. I hear the Lord saying right now, even things you have not even dreamed of. To transfer over, to draw your power from another source. So as I'm waiting on the Lord throughout the year, a few months ago, God says, recharge. And now, just like with the dimes a few years ago, with the color yellow, different things, God always confirms. What does He do? So look on the screen. I'm going to show you four that I just seen recently, articles that I just appeared. Look at the first one on the screen. Keep your spiritual batteries charged. I just seen that the other day. The second one. Charging your spiritual battery. Third one. The Christian Post. That's Greg Lowry. I know who he is. From Costa Mesa, California. Needing a recharge. This next one just came out just a couple days ago. Watch this. This just came out a couple days ago. 7 ways to recharge your prayer life. Does somebody in this house believe tonight that God is speaking to Encounter Church about a recharge? Now, there are items that need to be recharged. There are things that need to be recharged. Anything that has a battery, because even batteries are recharged. I was shaving not too long ago with my electric razor, and I did not have it plugged in. And I'm shaving my face, and in the middle of shaving my face, I was about halfway done, and the battery just died. Now, I don't like to go out with a half-shaven face. If I go out with a half-shaven face, I may walk like with my head on a tilt. But I ran out of juice. Listen to me. I ran out of power. And I did not expect it. I thought I'd be fully ready to go. There are many items. Some cameras. Some toys. There are toothbrushes. Dustbusters. I was with Pastor Derek at my house, what, 2 weeks ago?
Yes.
By my house 2 weeks ago. We were just doing some cleaning. And I took out my dustbuster. And it wouldn't work. A nice big thing. Because it was not in the charger. Are you catching this?
Yes.
I'm telling you about my personal life here. Smoke detectors. They require batteries. But sometimes you can recharge those batteries. Laptop computers. Here's one for you. Have you ever heard of a cell phone? iPhone? Smartphone? Of course. Now we have smartphone watches. Android watches. You can look at your watch and see who's calling you. If we are not accelerating in America, in the world, in the church, I don't know if we ever will, but we are. Let what God, let, let's see what God is doing and allowing the worldly system to do. And let's use that as an example that time is running out. In fact, the Lord said the days would be shortened in the last days, lest all mankind would perish. But when I think of my phone, man, no wonder why they call it a smartphone, because I got apps on here and apps and apps, and it's like, how in the world did I live without this thing? It has power. I can look up my bank accounts. I could give to ministries. I could look up my sports. I've got CNN news. I've got Fox News. I've got alerts. How many of you know what I'm talking about? I've got so many items on this phone. But then sometimes I look at it and I say, oh my, my battery's getting low and getting lower. And then I realize, as sophisticated as this phone is, as quickly as I can just tap a button, no matter how sophisticated this is. I was talking to my cousins today in Italy because they're 7 hours ahead of us. They were communicating with me by WhatsApp, Facebook. I was on Facebook today with people from around the world, all in the palm of my hand. But if it's not plugged in, and if it's not recharged, I can be out of communication. I can be out of touch. So it's so important that if this is just a phone, how much all the more we, the Church of Jesus Christ, made in His image, how much all the more spirit, soul, and body do we need to be recharged? Tonight I declare it's time for spirit, soul, and body. From the crown of your head to the soles of your feet to be completely recharged. If you're in agreement, give God a shout right now. I think of Ezekiel the prophet. When he prophesied about revival coming, and it started with the ankles. To me, that's like 25% power. I can do a little bit, but I cannot accomplish everything. And then he said the waters of revival came up to his knees. I call that 50%. Then it went up to his waist, 75%. I bet you right now, you don't have to do it, but I bet you right now there's not too many people in this room, if anyone, would look at their phone and see it at 100%. You may be at 80% or 90%, but I bet you some of you are at 30% or 20%. I'm here tonight to tell you, like the prophet Ezekiel said, God wants to saturate us with such a recharge that will not only bring us to 25% of blessing or 50% of blessing or 75% of blessing, but He wants to recharge us 100% with blessings that are too deep. He's going to recharge our entire being. Say, my entire being. Yeah, when you wait upon the Lord, Isaiah 40:31, when you wait upon the Lord, recharge. When you rest in the Lord, Psalm 46:10, recharge. When you pray in other tongues, Jude verse 20, there's only one chapter. When you pray in other tongues, he said, recharge. When you praise and worship, John 4:23, recharge. When you need to build your faith, Romans 10:17, Faith comes by hearing, recharging your faith with the Word of God. Recharging the anointing on your life. Psalm 92:10. Oh, without the anointing, we have nothing. But how many know every time we come into this house, we need a fresh anointing? We call that recharge. Deep calleth unto deep. Psalm 42:7. Recharge, recharge. Pray without ceasing. 1 Thessalonians 5:17. Recharging our spirit. Then our mind, say my mind. Romans 12, 1 and 2. Be transformed by the renewing of your mind. That's the recharging. Shout recharging.
Recharging.
The recharging of your mind. Philippians 4, 8. He says he wants to recharge your mind by putting in pure thoughts. Somebody needs to hear this really bad. Pure thoughts. Pure thoughts. Pure thoughts. Pure thoughts. Impure thoughts can lead to damaging somebody else's life, not just yours. Pure thoughts. Good thoughts. Healthy thoughts. Wholesome thoughts. Righteous thoughts. Pleasant thoughts. Philippians 4:8. This is a recharge that's going to come to your mind through the Word of God. Psalm 23, talking about our soul. He restoreth my soul. Recharge. Recharge of joy. How many can use a little recharge in your joy?
Amen.
Nehemiah chapter 8, verse 10. Recharge of joy. Charge of peace. John 14, 27. Listen to me. Recharge will cause you to speak the word. When you speak the word, Matthew 8:8, when you speak the word only, somebody say, speak the word only.
Speak the word only.
When you speak the word only, God will recharge you. When you speak the word only, say only.
Only.
That's where the recharge comes. Recharge. When you encourage yourself in the Lord, like David did in 1 Samuel chapter 30, verse 6. He encouraged himself in the Lord. Hear me, hear me, hear me. Sometimes life can be lonely. Sometimes ministry can be lonely. Sometimes even being married, you can feel lonely. Sometimes, no matter who you are, being single, it doesn't matter. Loneliness comes upon everybody or tries to. But I'm telling you, you can recharge your spiritual battery by encouraging yourself in the Lord, by speaking to yourself and saying, everything is going to be all right. Recharging your vision. Somebody needs to hear this. Proverbs 29:18. God is going to recharge your vision. Oh, I think of many times through the years when God has given me a prophetic word, or he's given me a dream, or he's given me a vision. And suddenly I realize a year's gone by and I have not activated it the way I needed to. And I go back and I say, God, forgive me for doing that. Recharge that dream back to my spirit, Lord. Recharge that dream back to my mind, Lord God. How many know what I'm talking about tonight?
Yes.
Then our body, spirit, soul, and body, recharge. Recharging your eyes. Recharging your mouth. Recharging your hands to be used for the glory of God. Recharging your feet. Recharging your legs. Recharging your knees. Recharging your joints. I'm prophesying to somebody tonight. All being recharged so that according to Psalm 103, we would be able to bless the Lord, all my soul, and all that is within me. I declare your physical body will be recharged with rest. The Holy Spirit is going to restore your health with a recharge. Recharge health. The Holy Spirit's going to recharge and heal your body and heal you. Hear me. Jeremiah 30:17 says, he will heal all your wounds. All your wounds will be healed. Jeremiah 30:17. If you just tap in, he'll recharge your entire body. Come on, somebody. Now listen. The Holy Spirit is going to recharge your relationships with godly covenant makers and only covenant makers. Because you don't need anybody canceling you out. You already have the devil against your assignment. You don't need people against your assignment. Iron is going to sharpen iron like iron has never been sharpened before. I call that recharging one another. Recharging in attending God's house. In other words, the more you're in his house, the more you're plugged in. The more you're plugged in, the greater the volume, the greater the velocity, the greater the strength. Can I get a witness? Increasing through recharging and serving in God's house. How many want to serve to another level? Recharge. How many have ever gotten tired and grown weary in doing good? Anybody in this house? How many have given financially and said, Lord, when? I've got good news for you. Galatians 6:9. Don't grow weary in doing good and sowing your seed, because God will recharge you and he'll give you more than enough. Can I get a witness? In 2018, he's going to recharge you with more love. Where before you would tolerate, you're going to learn to celebrate. Recharge you with his word. Recharge you in deeper devotions. Recharge you so that there's no room, hear me, that there's no room, because you're so recharged, your battery is so full of him, your spirit that is, that there's no room for disunity in your life. No room for division. No room for strife. Hear me. No room for offenses. You know why people get offended? They unplug. They run out of juice. Their spiritual immune system breaks down. And you can say they're pretty and they'll hear that they're ugly. That's because they're not plugged in. They're not tuned in. When you are recharged, you become a love machine. When you are recharged, God will flood you with joy. Come on, somebody. When you are recharged, as I said, if you grow weary in doing good, you get recharged and you'll be able to find a way to give again, to serve again, to love again, to live again. Come on, let's give God some glory tonight. Recharging in love. Recharging with his word, deeper devotion. There'll be no strife, jealousy. Here's one for you. Double-mindedness. Though I curse that spirit. When people's battery is running dry, their mind plays tricks on them. They think they heard God say, but God did not say. That's just a matter of their battery being drained because they've not been in the presence of God. They've not waited upon the Lord. They've not rested on the promises of God. They ran, but they did not rest. Confusion. Here's a word for somebody. Feeling insignificant. What is my life worth? When you are filled with a recharge, honey, you look at yourself in the morning and you say, I'm the apple of his eye. I'm the righteousness of God. I can and I will do all things. When you are recharged, you will not be in a place of displacement. You say, what do you mean displacement? When you're out of position, God cannot change your condition. But when you're in position, God will change your condition. When you're in position, God will give you a complete recharge and you will feel significant. You will not be confused. You will not have a double mind. There'll be no division among you. There'll be no strife among you. You will not take on offense or be jealous or double-minded or feel displaced because you're recharging in the presence of the Lord God Almighty. Now, in a little bit, I'm going to lay my hands on you. I mean, if you don't want to, I'm not going to force you. How many want a fresh impartation? Yeah. If that's you, shout, that's me.
That's me.
Wow. According to 1 Timothy 4:14, according to 1 Thessalonians 5:23, I'm going to lay my hands in you. According to these two verses, when Paul said, lay your hands and recharge and stir up that gift. I'm not going to impart the gift in you. It's already in you. We're going to stir that baby up. We're going to recharge that thing till you realize that God has a greater purpose for your life, a greater assignment for your life. But hear the word of the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord. You're hearing it now, but in 6 months from now, you got to get this thing. I'm telling you. In 3 months from now, you got to get this thing. On a Wednesday night, 2 months from now, you got to get this thing. On a Sunday morning, 4 months from today, you got to get this thing. You must stay plugged in. You must stay plugged in, or else your battery, it's real simple. You have a phone. You must stay plugged in or else your battery will run out of juice slowly but surely, and it could eventually die. I dare you to shout, not in this house. Recharge will strengthen you. The core, the remnant, will be recharged. And stay recharged. And I pray that the spirit of the remnant is upon all of you tonight. I pray that the spirit of the core, not the crowd, not even the congregation, and not even just the committed, but I said the core. Come on, I dare you to shout core. Speak that out to the atmosphere. Well, you're going to transfer from, if it is you, from being a spectator to a participator, if that would be you, but not in this house. The Holy Spirit, hear me, is not only going to restore, but recharge. But now, and this is where it gets really excited right now. The Lord in 2018, starting tonight, as we're still in 2017, it's going to carry over into midnight. Hear the word of the Lord. This is the most exciting thing I have to share tonight, or one of the most exciting things. The Lord is going to recharge your shout, and he's going to recharge your sound. I want that to sink in. I told you that this New Year's Eve service was going to be different. This night of destiny was going to be different than those in the past. God tonight is going to recharge your shout. He's going to recharge your sound. Now, every sound creates an environment. You know this. Every sound creates an environment. And your environment creates an atmosphere. Every sound creates an environment. And your environment creates an atmosphere. Just 2 nights ago, just maybe 100 yards from my home, I heard bang, bang, bang. Bang! And the first thought was, is somebody being shot? But it was not. It were people lighting off fireworks. When God sends you a sound, you need to have discernment to know that all good and perfect things come from above. Because there's imitation recharges. There's stuff that you may get cheaper somewhere else. Watered down. I won't get much more into it. I think you know what I'm saying. But God is going to recharge the sound of Encounter Church starting tonight. Every sound creates an environment, and your environment creates an atmosphere. Boring sounds create boredom. Sad sounds create sadness. Happy sounds creates happiness. Powerful sounds create power. Everything reproduces after its own kind. Praise sounds make you want to dance and clap. Worship sounds may want to cause you to bow or lift your hands. Now listen to this very carefully. I'm going to teach you a little bit. The Bible, now remember this word sound. Say I will. The Bible speaks of three heavens. How many?
Three.
And I'm going to shake up some of your theology. Somebody say, it's okay.
It's okay.
Because we'll always stick with God's. Not the new one that comes out every 10 years. And it lasts for 6 months and it brings division. And people get rich on their book, but people get poor in their spirit. Come on, I dare to shout, not in this place. There are three heavens. How many?
Three.
The one is right above your head. This earth. God created this earth to be a heaven. God didn't create this earth for sickness. He created this earth as a heaven in its original form. That's the first heaven. The second heaven is called the heavenlies. You look up, you see the stars. That's a second heaven. Now, this is interesting. God created the first heaven, which was supposed to be this earth. Then there's the second heaven. That's above. Then there's the third heaven. That's where my daddy is tonight. My mama, Julia DiPalma, that's where she is, in the third heaven. So there's this earth. Then there's the atmospheric realm above us. And then there's heaven. Are you getting this?
Yes.
The second heaven was named in the Bible. It was called the firmament. Created in the book of Genesis. You'll read about this. Now here is the scenario. Remember, God is going to give us a new sound. He's going to change the sound. All right? So there's heaven number one, this earth. Heaven number two, that's the heavenlies above the earth, firmament. And heaven number three, heaven, where God is seated and Jesus, his son, sits next to him, ever ready to make intercession for you. Are you catching this? Okay. There's a problem here, church. There's a problem. There is a reason why some of us have not received greater breakthroughs. And tonight is going to be the night to discover why. There are some of us that should have much more money in our bank accounts, but we have less money. There are some of us that should be walking in greater health, but we're not. Now, we're not here to judge. We're here to discover. And God has shown me a revelation here. That this earth, heaven, was ordained for us never to be sick. God never When you drew out the plans for this earth, hospitals were never included. Doctors, in all due respect, we need them now, were never included the way God originally wanted this earth to be. Now, before we look at these three heavens, and I explain to you why sometimes our prayers get intercepted, why sometimes we pray for a breakthrough and it doesn't come, I just want to give you just a little illustration of what sounds can do. Because tonight there's going to be a recharge in your sound, and it's going to bring you to a place you ain't been in a long time. Here's an example. Get militant. Now stop right there. Now, does that sound like a wedding march to you?
No.
Does that sound like a funeral?
No.
Does that make you just want to get up on your feet and beat the devil? Because a sound creates an atmosphere. And atmospheres bring change. That's why you have to watch your words. Because your words create life. Your words, hear me! Your words create depression. We often say depression is a spirit. Why don't we start saying this? Depression is what comes out of my mouth by declaring and decreeing it. I need more joy. Speak it out. Not play me something contrary. Totally contrary. Is that peaceful? Peaceful? You like that sound? But both are necessary to bring you into the realm of God's heavenly places. Now give me a sound that's depressing. Been trained by our culture that if we're at a funeral, we're supposed to be depressed. Now listen, we all mourn and we all grieve. But there's coming a recharge of a sound from heaven that's going to create an atmosphere that you'll be able, and I'm saying this by the Spirit, you will be able to write your own ticket with God's blessings by the words you speak and by your understanding of these three heavens. Now we're back to the three heavens. The first heaven is supposedly where we're living in now, according to the Bible. Okay? The second heaven is the firmament. The third heaven is where God has his abode. Right now, Satan and his demons occupy the second heaven. You say, I thought the devil's in hell. Find me, prove it to me. I thought demons were in hell. May I remind you, according to the word of God, your Jesus, my Jesus said in Matthew 25:41, he said that hell is reserved for the devil and his angels. If it's reserved, it means they have not shown up yet. Now, are there people in hell right now being tormented? Absolutely. That's what hell and brimstone fire does. But Satan's army of angels or demons are in the second realm of the heavenlies. Are you hearing me?
Yes.
That's why the Bible calls it wickedness in heavenly places. Does the Bible say that?
Yes.
Does the Bible say that Satan is the prince and power of the air? God created the second heaven for you to enjoy. The sun, the moon, the stars. But Satan, his domain is in the second heaven, but God rests in the third heaven. So now there's a problem here. We are in the first heaven. God is in the third heaven. But then there's a blockage, if you would. There's a barrier called the second heaven. Daniel cried out for 21 days in Daniel chapter 10. He cried out to God for 21 days over a dream that he had. He fasted. He prayed. Some of us fast and pray and don't get our breakthrough. Some of us give and give, but don't get our breakthrough. Daniel, a mighty man of God, he fasted and prayed for 21 days. And his angel was delayed. 21 days. Why? Because there was a war in the second heaven. And finally, the Lord had to bring in one of his archangels. He said, you come over here and you take care of business. I want you to know tonight, God heard your prayer 21 days ago. God heard your prayer 21 weeks ago, 21 months ago, 21 years ago. But there's been this blockage in the heavenly realm where God ordained for the sun and the moon and the stars. Why do you think we've had so many earthquakes this year? So many hurricanes from Puerto Rico to Mexico and all these disasters where people to this day, they're still without what? Power. I have come here tonight to tell you that tonight God's going to recharge us with a sound. So heaven number one is within you. Yes, it's this earth, but the kingdom of God also resides within you. And tonight there's going to be a recharge that's going to take you to a place that's going to pierce the darkness into the heavenlies so that his kingdom will come and that his will be done. Get ready. And that which has been loosed in heaven will be loose on earth. I've come tonight to tell you there's a recharge of a new sound coming to the house of the Lord. In 1 Corinthians 14:8, it says there was a certain sound. Some of your Bibles say an uncertain sound, but there is a certain sound. Tonight I submit to Encounter Church. I submit to you those watching in Israel right now, those around the world in New York, those of you on Long Island, those of you in California, those of you in Nebraska, no matter where you are watching, whatever time, day it is, God is recharging your life and he's going to accelerate you to another place because that second barrier called the second heaven, God's going to open up the heavens and he's going to bring greater angels because there's not going to be that barrier, the blockage anymore because there's coming a new sound. As I said, Paul the Apostle said in 1 Corinthians 14:8, there's going to come a certain sound. Somebody shout a certain sound. You just heard certain sounds minutes ago. Sounds can depress you. Sounds can encourage you. Sounds can uplift you. Sounds can take you out of depression. Sounds can put you in depression.
I'm here today to tell you that there's going to come a sound from heaven with a recharge in this house tonight. And it's going to pierce through the second heavens. It's going to pierce through the darkness where Satan rules over, where demons and principalities and rulers of darkness on high, they've got to be pushed aside. According to Luke 11:24, they have to scatter into desolate and dry places to the glory of God. There's coming a certain sound, but let me tell you, for it to reach the heaven where God sits, he's going to give you stronger angels, greater angels, but not only that, the power of Christ that already resides within you is going to be so recharged that your shout is going to be like none other. Your intercessory prayer is going to be like none other. Your church attendance, don't shout me down, your church attendance is going to be like none other. Your giving, your serving, your living, your loving, your attitude is going to be like none other. Where that barrier is going to come down, let me tell you something, and all of heaven is going to break loose. And what took 10 years, you'll get in 10 days. You'll get in 10 hours. You'll get, listen, I ain't playing around. You'll get in 10 minutes. I call this an acceleration, but a continuation of acceleration. It's a recharge. Isn't it interesting that the Bible says that when the Lord returns, there's going to be a certain sound, a shout, a trumpet sound. Hear me. And the dead in Christ shall rise. And those who are alive and remain, that's us, will meet them in the air. It does not say we're going to meet them in heaven. It says we're going to meet them in the air. It doesn't say here. It says air, which means when the Lord returns and our loved ones who knew the Lord, their bodies are going to rise up. We, the church, are going to be raptured up. And we're going to consume that second heaven and take back our dominion. And there'll be a meeting in the air. And then the devil's going to come down to this earth. And during that 7-year tribulation, he'll try to deceive everyone as much as he can. So heaven number one, did you get it?
Yes.
Heaven number two, did you get it?
Yes.
Heaven number three, after the Lord returns, we'll meet in the air and say, devil, you demons, get out of here. Get out of the way. Get out my way. And then we'll be in the third heaven. And when we're in that third heaven, God will wipe away every tear. There'll be no more sickness. There'll be no more mourning, but only peace and joy forevermore. Tonight, when God recharges you, it's going to require, according to 1 Corinthians 14:8, a certain sound. Sometimes it's a certain gift that makes a difference. Cornelius sowed a certain seed that got heaven's attention. Sometimes it's a certain praise that releases something in the atmosphere. Sometimes it's a certain worship. That's why sometimes we need to get the right song. So there are good songs, but it's got to be the right song. There's good environments, but it's got to be the right environment. And when God recharges us with Palo Santo, when he recharges us with it, heaven will come down and glory will fill your soul. And tonight, right after midnight, he's going to recharge us with a new sound. And I'm not talking about noisemakers, but he's going to give us a new sound that's going to take us to a place we've never been. Are you ready for it? I said, are you ready for it? Israel, the preparation of what God's doing in these last days of now, the embassy coming to Jerusalem. It's all a sign of the imminent return of the Lord Jesus Christ. Preparation for the temple for the Jews to come and worship during the tribulation. While we're in heaven, the third heaven. But until that day, may the Lord recharge us and may we occupy till He comes. This has been the word of the Lord.